Did you know that a data scientist is titled 2019's most promising job in the US? As per a recent survey from Glassdoor and LinkedIn, data scientists have consistently been ranked at number one because of their high demand in the business and tech industries. With this in mind, let's start today's session. Hi guys, I'm Zulekha from Edureka and I welcome you to this session on data scientist resume. So let's take a look at the agenda for today. We're going to begin this session by understanding who exactly a data scientist is. Then we'll move on and look at the job trends in the market for a data scientist. We'll also discuss a few of the salary trends in the market, and we'll finally move on and discuss the job description of a data scientist. Over here, we'll go through a couple of job descriptions and we'll try to understand what exactly companies look for in a data scientist. Next, we'll discuss the skill set of a data scientist. What are the skills that are needed to become a successful data scientist? We'll finally end the session by looking at a data scientist sample resume, and we'll discuss a few tips and tricks so that you can build your own resume. All right, so I hope all of you are clear with the agenda. Now let's get started with our first topic. So before we get started with who exactly a data scientist is, let's see how data science emerged in the first place. Alright, so let's take a look at some of the stats about the data that is being produced today. First of all, every 2 days, we create as much data as we did from the beginning of time until 2003. Now, that's a lot of data that we create in just 2 days. Another such fact is that Google processes over 40,000 search queries every second, which translates to over 3.5 billion searches per day and 1.2 trillion searches per year worldwide. Also, poor data analysis across businesses and the government costs the US economy $3.1 trillion a year. Now, guys, that's a lot of loss. So basically, companies and businesses that do not perform data analysis and data processing properly, they can face a huge amount of loss. All right, so the correct method to implement data science and data analysis can help you save up a lot of money. Also, for a typical Fortune 1000 company, just a 10% increase in the data accessibility will result in more than 65 million additional net income. Now, that is a lot of profit. So basically, if a Fortune 1000 company gets at least a 10% increase in their data accessibility, then they can see a huge change in their business. All right, their business will grow a lot because they have more data to study and more insights to draw from those data. All right, so enough with the facts. Now, let me tell you that initially we made use of traditional business intelligent tools to process data. Now, we did this because back then we generated very little data and therefore we didn't require any complex tools. All right, so simple business intelligent tools would do the trick. But these stats clearly show that we're producing data at an unstoppable pace. And obviously, we require a more complex and a structured process to analyze this much data. All right, this process is nothing but data science. So guys, data science is a way to get the value out of your data so that you can use it to grow your business. All right, now let's move ahead and discuss who exactly a data scientist is. Now, if you ask me, a data scientist is a lot like a detective, just like Sherlock Holmes. Now, the only difference I see is that Sherlock Holmes solves murder mysteries, whereas a data scientist solves data mysteries such as detecting trends and patterns, extracting useful insights, forming hypotheses, and building predictive models in order to find a solution. All right, so here's a definition of a data scientist. Now, a data scientist is a professional who possesses the ability to transform raw data into useful insights in order to make better business decisions. So basically, a data scientist uses the past data or the data that is collected by the business, and it finds correlations and patterns within those data in order to make better business decisions. Okay, so basically, a data scientist will study the data in such a way that he draws out some useful insights in such a way that the company or the business will grow. All right. Now, guys, to become a data scientist, you have to be an expert in technologies such as R, MATLAB, SQL, Python, and so on. You must also possess a data-driven problem-solving approach, a strong business acumen, and expertise in statistics, predictive modeling, data manipulation, data wrangling, and visualization. Okay. We'll discuss more about the skills required in the further slides. Now let's discuss a few job trends for a data scientist in the market. Now guys, with a career advancement score of 9 out of 10, LinkedIn listed data scientist at first place in the best jobs in US March 2019 issue, right, which is quite recent actually. In the recent issue that was released by LinkedIn, it was stated that data scientist is going to be the most promising job role in US. Now, these surveys are not just released from LinkedIn. There are a lot of surveys from Glassdoor, which also show that data scientist is one of the most growing and the most prosperous job roles in today's market. So coming to this table shows how the job listings of a data scientist varies with respect to the geography. Okay, so I've collected this information from Indeed. And if you look at the table, it says that in New York, there are around 2,035 job listings or vacancies for a data scientist. Okay, similarly, in Seattle, we have around 1,906 listings. And for San Francisco, there's 1,465 and so on. So guys, there are a lot of vacancies for you to apply as a data scientist. All you need is the skills and the will to learn. All right. Now let's look at another graph over here. Now this graph basically shows the vacancies of data scientist jobs as per a percentage of all the IT jobs in United Kingdom. Okay. This graph also clearly shows that in UK, there is a lot of opening for a data scientist. Now this is because a lot of businesses and companies are looking for a data scientist. All right, they need somebody who can understand the data very well and try to draw insights and useful patterns so that they can grow their business. This is exactly why a data scientist has such a huge demand in the market. They are basically individuals who derive value from data so that you can make better business decisions. Now, before I move on and discuss the salary trends, I'd also like to tell you another fact. Okay, so basically IBM predicts that by 2020, the number of data science and analytic job listings will grow by nearly 364,000 listings. So guys, it's clear that the demand for a data scientist is only going to increase by the day. All right. Now let's discuss the salary trends. So guys, before we start discussing the numbers, I want to tell you that the salary of a data scientist varies depending on their experience, their region, and their skill set. Okay. But as per pay scale, the salary of a data scientist ranges between $63,000 to $130,000 with a median pay of around $91,000. Now, the salary, like I mentioned earlier, will depend on factors like geography, skill set, level of experience, and the company you're working for. Now, let's look at how the salary varies depending on the geography. So, for example, if you look at this table, in New York, a data scientist is paid around $137,000 on an average. In Seattle, it's around $152,000. Now, this number is not fixed. It totally depends on your skill set and your experience. So if you have a more varied list of skills in your resume, then 100% you're going to earn much more than this. All right, there are a lot of data scientists who earn up to $180,000. Okay, there are a lot of them. Now let's look at how the data scientist salary varies with respect to the company. So here you can see that companies like Facebook, Microsoft, Apple, Twitter, and Google, they pay a good amount to a data scientist. Okay, this is just the average salary. Like I mentioned, your salary will increase or decrease depending on your skill set or depending on your experience. Okay, so for example, on an average, Facebook pays around $135,000 to a data scientist. Okay, similarly, Microsoft is at around $120,000, Apple at around $130,000, and so on. Okay, Twitter, there is $134,000. So guys, what I'm trying to say is your salary will depend on your skill set. It will depend on the level of experience and the number of projects you have done in data science. Okay, it really depends on all the work that you've put into becoming a successful data scientist. All right, before we move any further, I'd like to show you another stat. All right, I collected this stat from Stack Overflow. And this basically shows the median salary for various type of developers. And here you can see that data scientists have managed to secure a position within the top 4 most highly paid professionals in the world. Okay, in Germany, a data scientist stands at position number 4. In India, it's at number 2. In United Kingdom, it's at number 3. And in United States, it's at number 2. Now, guys, this report was formulated in 2018. The recent report is not out yet. I'm not sure if it's out, but in that report, data scientists will definitely be at number one in the United States, because it was recently announced that the most trending job or the most promising job in the United States is of a data scientist. Now let's move on and look at a few job descriptions of a data scientist. Okay, we'll try to understand what exactly companies look for in a data scientist. Here I have a job description from Tech Mahindra. Now the points or the keywords that I've highlighted basically tell us what skills these companies are actually looking for. Okay, these are the skills that you need to master in order to become a successful data scientist. So first of all, here there's written that you need to have expertise in machine learning and deep learning. So no matter which company you join, you're always going to be asked in-depth questions about machine learning and deep learning. Apart from that, the statistical languages like Python and R are really helpful. Okay, they are one of the most important tools or technologies that you need to know in order to become a data scientist. Okay, and you also need to have a good knowledge of TensorFlow. They've also mentioned the data manipulation process. Okay, so basically the entire data lifecycle, you have to be very efficient and you have to have a clear understanding of the entire data lifecycle. Okay, the data lifecycle basically starts with data collection, where you collect data. After that, there is data cleaning, where you get rid of any missing values or any inconsistencies in your data, followed by data analysis and exploration. All right, here you analyze your data and try to draw useful insights from your data. Okay, so like you can see here again, they've mentioned data discovery and exploration. Okay, to build and test hypotheses and draw insights. Now, building and testing hypotheses basically involve building machine learning models or building predictive models. All right, so you have to have a good understanding of predictive models, machine learning algorithms, and so on. Next, they've mentioned statistical and machine learning and deep learning algorithms. I've already spoken about machine learning and deep learning algorithms. And when it comes to statistics, guys, statistics is one of the most important tools of a data scientist. They have to know statistics in and out, okay? Whether it's probability theory, whether it is statistical testing, or whether it is linear algebra, they need to know a little bit of math as well, okay? It's a prerequisite for a data scientist. Now let's look at another job description. Now this job description I've collected from Philips. Now they've mentioned that you have to have an experience in development using artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. So like I mentioned earlier, machine learning, deep learning, AI is going to be a prerequisite in order to become a data scientist. Okay, because data science is basically an umbrella term for artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. Okay, it's much vaster than that, but basically data science makes use of techniques from AI, machine learning, and deep learning in order to draw useful insights from data. Okay. So if you ask me how data science process is used to draw useful insights from data, it's through artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. All right, there are other techniques as well, but these three are very important terminologies or technologies within data science. Now, apart from that, you have to have a strong hold on statistics and expertise in natural language processing, text mining, and text analytics. Now, guys, the demand for NLP and text mining is increasing day by day. A lot of people are looking for skilled data scientists who know how to perform text mining and text analytics. Okay, so it's very important that you know how to perform these things. Apart from that, of course, you need programming skills. R and Python, like I mentioned earlier, are very important statistical programming languages when it comes to data science. All right, if you just open the internet and type data science, you'll see only tutorials on R and Python. Okay, because R and Python are the most important tools of the trade. Okay, then apart from that, there are big data frameworks like Hadoop, Spark. Okay, that's also very necessary because we're dealing with a lot of data when it comes to data science. Okay, and then of course, you need to be good at querying databases like Mongo database, Postgres, Cassandra, and so on. Finally, they've also mentioned the data lifecycle, which includes data integration, processing, analytics, reporting, and visualization. Okay, so guys, these things are quite important, and most of the job descriptions that I went through had these set of skills listed in their job description. Okay, so it's quite important that you know at least these set of skills in order to become a data scientist or in order to get hired. Okay, Now, in order to give you a clearer picture of the skills required, let's list down the skills that a data scientist commonly has. So first of all, like I mentioned, you need statistics. Okay, statistics and math are really important when it comes to data science, followed by programming languages, data extraction and processing, data wrangling and exploration, machine learning, deep learning, big data processing frameworks, and data visualization. So let's discuss each of these skill sets in a little more detail. So guys, statistics will basically give you the numbers from the data. Okay, so a good understanding of statistics is very important for a data scientist. You have to be familiar with statistical tests, distributions, maximum likelihood estimators. You also require descriptive statistics, probability theory. All of these are minimum requirements. Okay, you have to have a really good understanding of statistics. Now, these concepts will basically help you make better decisions and it'll help you get a more quantitative look at your data. Okay, so it'll help you get the numbers from your data. So statistics is very important in data science. Next, we have programming languages. Now, guys, no matter what type of company or role you're interviewing for, you're always going to be expected to know how to use the tools of the trade. This means that you need to know statistical programming languages like R and Python, and a database querying language like SQL. Okay, it's very important that you know at least these three languages because a data scientist has to use such languages in order to derive all the insights from data. Okay, so it's very important that you know the basic programming languages in data science, which is R, Python, and SQL. All right, now let's look at the data extraction and processing. Since data science is all about data, you have to know how to extract data from databases like MySQL database, Mongo database, and so on. Once you've extracted it, you have to transform that data into a proper format so that you can query and explore the data to find any trends or any patterns or anything that might help grow the business. Okay. Also, you need to know how to load the data into a warehouse for analysis. That's about data extraction and processing. Next, we have data wrangling and exploration. Now, guys, data wrangling is just another word for data cleaning. Okay, it basically means that in this stage, you're going to deal with any missing values, any redundant data, or any formatting issues. Okay, you have to make sure your data is clean and you have to get rid of all the inconsistencies in this stage. Okay, now once your data is all clean, you're going to make use of a process known as exploratory data analysis to extract trends, patterns, and useful insights. Now, this is one of the most important stages in the data lifecycle. Okay, this is where you dig deep and you try to form hypotheses and, you know, you come up with a different sort of algorithms to solve your problem and you check which algorithm or which model will best solve your problem. Okay, so that's about data wrangling and exploration. Now, let's look at machine learning. Now, obviously, you have to be familiar with machine learning algorithms. There are a lot of algorithms in machine learning and, you know, they're very specific. So if you want to solve a problem which involves predicting an output class, then you can make use of classification algorithms like support vector machines. You can make use of logistic regression and so on. Okay, clustering models or clustering algorithms are also available. So KNN and K-means are good clustering models. Apart from that, we have regression and association algorithms as well. So guys, machine learning is very important. You have to master the machine learning algorithms. You have to know how they work in and out. Now, if any of you are interested in machine learning algorithms, I'll leave a set of links in the description wherein we'll be covering different machine learning algorithms and each of the video will show you a practical demonstration of how you can implement machine learning. Next, we have deep learning. Now, deep learning is nothing but advanced machine learning concepts. This is where neural networks come in and building advanced models is one very important phase in deep learning. Okay, there is also reinforcement learning models. Now, reinforcement learning is a type of machine learning which has just begun to grow. And it involves a little more complex algorithms like Q-learning and so on. Okay, so it's very important for you to know deep learning as well as machine learning. Okay, now let's look at our next skill, which is big data processing frameworks. Now, we know that we're going to be dealing with a huge amount of data when it comes to data science. So the single most important thing here is you have to know how to structure the data and how to handle that data. Okay, for that, you need big data processing frameworks like Hadoop and Spark. Okay, so make sure you master these frameworks because they're pretty much there in every job description. Next, we have data visualization. Now, a lot of people don't pay a lot of attention to data visualization, but data visualization is the only way you can show your capabilities. Okay, you have to show your numbers at the end of the day. Okay, you have to show where exactly your business is growing and what exactly is going wrong, or which part or which department in your business is causing a problem, and so on. Okay, this can be done only using data visualization. Now, there are a lot of tools in the market for data visualization, but usually people look for experts in Tableau and Power BI and so on. Okay, so make sure you master these tools. Now, guys, that was it for data scientist skills. Now, let's move on and look at a data scientist sample resume. So I created a sample resume in order to make you understand what exactly you should put in your resume. So an introduction is very necessary. Make sure it's a simple and a short introduction, but also make sure that it draws attention. Make sure you sneak in your skills and your experience in the introduction. So I've written that a data scientist with N plus years of hands-on experience in delivering valuable insights via data analytics and advanced data-driven methods. Also proficient in building statistical models using R and Python. So here I'm not only mentioned my experience, I've also mentioned a few skills. Okay. Now the education field, I'll let you guys deal with it. Y'all can fill out the education field according to your education. Now within the experience field, you have to list down all the projects that you've done, all the data science related projects, whether it's text mining, whether it is NLP, whether it is a predictive modeling, whether it's building machine learning algorithms, deep learning algorithms, anything. You have to mention all your data science projects in your experience field. Here I mentioned I've used Python and Spark to scrape, clean, and analyze large data sets. All right, so I'm basically saying that I have good enough information about the data lifecycle. I know how to clean and I know how to analyze and explore data sets. Then I've said created machine learning models with Python. And I've also mentioned that I've created a model that is used to predict energy usage of commercial buildings with 98% accuracy. Now, guys, mentioning your projects is very important, all right, because that's the only proof of your capability. So you have to impress your interviewer over here. You have to show him all the projects you've done and, you know, how they have changed or contributed to your company. So next, I've mentioned design and develop real-time recommendation engines, and then transformed raw data into MySQL. And finally, I've mentioned expertise in Tableau for data visualization. So guys, make sure you don't skip data visualization. There are a lot of data scientists who don't pay much attention to data visualization. Data visualization is one of the most important aspects of a data lifecycle, because here you're showing the stats and you're trying to show the growth in the company, or how a particular variable or how a particular product is affecting the business. Okay, that you can clearly show using data visualization. Then I've mentioned a few skills. Here I've mentioned proficient in languages such as R and Python. Now this has to be your number one skill. Okay, you have to know R and Python very well. Then there is strong understanding of predictive modeling and machine learning algorithms, which I mentioned earlier. Okay, machine learning algorithms and predictive modeling are very, very important. Predictive modeling is nothing but using machine learning algorithms in order to predict an outcome. Okay, good understanding of data mining, cleaning, and modeling. Again, here I'm trying to mention the data lifecycle. And then I've said efficient in graphical modeling and data visualization using Tableau, and an in-depth understanding of deep learning using neural networks. So guys, this was the entire data scientist resume. If any of you have any doubts or want any help in building your resume, please leave your queries in the comment section. All right, I'll try to answer all your queries. Now, before I end the session, I'll just give you a few key points that you should keep in mind while you're building your resume. So first of all, try and state your career objective. Okay, make it clear and precise. State exactly what you're applying for and where your interest lies. Now, within the educational qualification, you can mention your bachelor's degree, your master's degree. And usually people with the background of computer science or statistics are preferred. All right, but I'm not saying that it's necessary. There are a lot of data scientists who don't have a matching or an equivalent data scientist degree. It's not a prerequisite, but mostly people with a computer science or a statistics background are preferred. All right. Now, next, you can mention your professional experience. So basically, in your experience, you can mention your contributions to the company. Okay, you can write about machine learning models that you created, and you can see how it, you know, solved the business problem and how it benefited your organization. After that, you can mention your technical and your non-technical skills. Now, what are technical skills? Now, guys, technical skills are the practical abilities acquired from working on real-time projects and working on field. Okay, so basically, you have to prove your capabilities by listing out your skills. So make sure you list out all your technical and all your relevant skills only in this. Okay, because this is the best way to impress your interviewer by telling him how much you know and how much you've worked on, and therefore you know these many tools or these many technologies. Now, in the non-technical skills, you can impress your interviewer by showing him how strong your communication skills are and how strong your intellect or your analytical thinking is. Okay, because a data scientist is not somebody who is a hardcore programmer. You have to have very good business acumen. You have to have very good communication skills because you're handling a business. Okay, a data scientist is going to talk to other stakeholders, communicate their company's stats to other stakeholders. So data scientists has to have excellent communication skills. All right. So guys, that was it for the data scientist resume. If you have any doubts regarding today's session or if you want any help building your data scientist resume, please leave your queries in the comment section and we'll get back to you at the earliest. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it and you can comment any of your doubts and queries and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!